There's a place called a gin mill way down in the slums. There's a place called a gin mill way down in the slums. My baby goes that night and stays till the morning comes.
Hey, you guys, it's Blind Pick Confessions back with another show. We got Brennan. Cowboy.
Hey.
So if Pat,
I'm sorry.
I'm exhausted. Whatever. My name's Dave.
Hey, how you doing?
If Pat ever starts a show like that,
it's bad.
Yeah, that more than likely, it's going to be an after-hours show.
That was awful.
This isn't going
to
air.
You want me to start over
it?
Again?
No, it'll sure? air.
No, that was perfect.
But we're here. It's October.
It is October.
We're doing, there's going to be a few Halloween-themed shows coming out. And, We decided to do. We got Dave from Pearl Street.
Not from Pearl Street. We're in Pearl Street.
Well, we are. We're doing another show here.
We're in and from and.
Yeah, and
about.
they got Vinny.
Are you really that worried about tents right now?
What's that?
Are you really that worried about tents?
Yeah, he's a grammar Nazi.
Yeah, Jesus.
I'm a grammar Nazi
too.
Are you?
Maybe that's a Michigan thing too. I don't know.
You get on Facebook and you're like, fucking assholes.
Yeah, I do, and I correct their grammar.
I always like the people who put out they'll share some meme and whatever, and it's like it's got all kinds of grammar problems in it, and they're trying to say something really, profound.
I seen them down at the Crick.
Yeah, they're all trying to be profound, and it's got nothing but grammar problems in it, and I'm like, no, I'm done.
But well, those are the ones I love the most, is that you get somebody that will post like just this disgusting, like funny sexual meme. And then the next one is like, pray for, just some Jesus meme. I'm like, what the fuck?
I'm always a fan of somebody that morally corrects me with improper grammar.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, I can't listen to you anymore.
I legitimately think Dave needs to come on our shows more often because he gets our sense of humor.
He does.
I like Vinny, and our alcohol content.
I think we need to have Vinny on with us more. He doesn't say a lot.
Vinny
won't
shut up.
But when he does, it's off the chain.
When he does, it's
hilarious.
It's
silent Vinny. Yeah.
We need to come up with a voice for Vinny. Like,
yo, Vinny.
Or
it's Vinny.
Yeah, like, so he can have a voice.
Flavor Flav.
All right, not that one.
No, maybe not.
Oh, my God. It might take a while.
You're stealing my hot sauce?
Oh, here comes summer.
Did you just steal my hot sauce?
Oh, summer. Put them headphones on, lady.
We need a drum roll.
All right, for our Halloween, one of our Halloween episodes, we're gonna get summer.
Legitimately,
on.
We've been trying to get this to happen for how long?
A year.
Yeah, you actually got to talk into the mic. You can't just.
What you mean this mic right here?
Yeah. So a chili cook-off, I think, was the last time we tried to get this going.
Yeah. Yeah, we did. I was pretty drunk at that one, so. There
but
was
you
would
talk then,
yeah.
Yeah. But we thought that was the time that it would happen.
No, you don't want to see me drunk on the radio. That's not going to be good.
We can't, though.
That's exactly the point.
that's what happens with Cowboy every episode.
That's why we don't film. Like, why do you guys don't do YouTube? And, like, no. Have you seen this? No.
Have you seen it? No.
Absolutely not.
Because half the time, everybody's naked.
Oh.
Shh. Well, third show.
Yeah.
The second show.
In the third hour, yeah. The third hour gets...
At least pants off, right?
Yeah, pants off, all kinds of awkward.
Yeah. Guys, this is a family establishment, so we're going to need to keep clothes on.
We're on the bar side.
I don't know, Vinny,
Vinny
is, we were just talking about trying to come up with a voice for Vinny.
Vinny ain't got no clothes on. You're not getting on his case.
Yep.
Yeah, well, we're waiting on his uniform to show up. He has a shirt coming. So
no shirts, no shoes. Vinny's should be out.
Is that like a preemie shirt?
Yeah, I had to actually go and get like a kid's shirt.
Yeah, I imagine, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. I'm excited for Vinny.
I know. I love Vinny. He's great.
Yeah? But we actually know you from Scarlet Lane, correct?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Brennan knows you from a little bit longer, but...
Nickel plate days.
Nickel plate. Yeah.
Are any of Cowboy's dead babies on display at there right now?
I'm pretty sure there's a bunch of dead babies on
display
over there.
Yeah. So, Scarlet Lane, one time I asked Elise, I was like, look, I got to get rid of some dead babies. Do you want them? And she goes, without hesitation, like, I figured somebody would... Like that,
Western
throw a red
return.
Flag. She's like, "Yep,
yep, all of them."
And that was the whole conversation.
Yeah.
And so one day I show up to Scarlet Lane with tubs. I've got like four tubs of dead babies. I go, "Hey, I'm dropping off dead babies for Elise." And they're like, "Okay."
Is there a metaphor? medical biohazard sticker on that one.
Yeah. I was just like, and at that point I realized, like, I probably should preface this, but I didn't.
No,
like,
there's
like,
no need
I
to.
Realized it.
Yeah, not over
like,
there.
Nah,
they get it.
Nah.
They get it.
But yeah. I did get a look like, dead babies?
Dead babies?
Like, maybe that's a line they cross there.
Yeah.
But at the same time, they're like, nah,
nope.
It's all right.
Yeah. No, they're actually on display. So
nice.
Yeah. They're planning the Halloween party for next weekend, and they're like, well, we should put the dead babies out. No, somebody will steal it, and then that makes Elise mad. You don't want to
oh,
make Elise mad.
Yeah.
We don't do that.
You got to chain them down.
Yeah.
You gotta chain
the dead babies.
I truly do miss my dead babies, but they're in a good home.
Well, you can go visit them.
Yeah.
In which I do. Don't get me wrong.
We're actually trying to get.
I do.
Want to get Scarlet Lane next week to visit us at Tippy's for our Halloween event, but they're got their own Halloween event next week. So, but you know,
that's all right. We'll get out there again.
We gotta get back to Scarlet.
They got their new place opening up, right?
Yep. Two new places.
Two new places. Holy shit!
Wow. Yeah. I didn't know it was two. I only knew the one.
South
well, the
Meridian,
first one came about, and then Rotterdam. All of a sudden that second one just kind of sprung about.
Oh,
right?
Okay. It must have been. I thought it was the same one. Okay.
Yeah.
No.
Two places.
So, but they're going Final Gravity right next door, right?
I think so.
Yeah. That.
Oh, really? Next door? Oh, shit.
Yeah. So they bought a building, correct? And that next door location, they kind of said, hey, Bill, come on.
In one year.
Let's do this.
Yeah. It's going to be exciting for them.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's solid because they brewed Bill Stout, what, last year?
I think it was last year, yeah.
Well, talking about Scarlet Lane, you know, their thing is gore and Halloween. I mean, this is their season, right? I mean, so.
Yeah. Well, their season goes all year long.
They're all year long. But, this is the best time to be Scarlet Lane
fans. And if Dave would let me, we would have Halloween here all year long.
I was going to say, this is a summer's holiday as well, right?
Yes. Well, you have plans for Vinny to keep going. I mean, that's what's good.
Yes,
so,
he's gonna stick around. He's our newest employee. You know, he's got some sketchy past, but, you know, he's at least half of a body.
Absolutely.
For us, so.
We're going to make some little rabbit ears for him for Easter. And
yeah. He's just going to keep going.
I mean, he'll have a
or,
leprechaun
or a Jesus
costume.
Beard, whatever you want.
Yeah. Leprechaun costume, you
little,
know.
Yeah. Little cross.
We'll dress him up as Cupid.
Put him on. Wow.
Sorry, maybe not.
So Dave said last episode he's offering half off their bill if they find out
no,
where
he's
at.
No, not bill. No, appetizer.
Oh, appetizer.
Jesus, man. You just.
Dave's like, what?
We knew this was going to happen eventually, though.
Yeah. If they could find out where Vinny is and they could post a picture
on
Facebook.
I'll pay your mortgage.
For anybody.
And if you believe that.
I got some land in Florida to sell you.
So, by the way, you did bring us Oktoberfest for the whole
time.
I'm
liking the Oktoberfest. It's beautiful.
Yeah. Whose Oktoberfest is this?
Hofbräu.
Hofbräuhaus.
Hofbräuhaus.
Yeah?
The OG in the München.
The München, yep.
So they have opened up locations across the United States. Cincinnati was their first location in the United States, correct?
Yeah, I think they're in every party city now.
They are. Yep. Indy, we don't have a Hofbräuhaus, which I think we need to.
Really?
Right here?
Well, I'm going to debate now. Now I want to have a little
friendly
debate.
See,
let's go.
This is what I
let's
love.
Go.
Yeah, let's do this.
We have a beautiful German brew house, beer garden, right downtown Indy on Mass Ave.
Yes.
Who?
Are you joking?
I mean, there's Raskeller, but it's not a brew house.
It's a beer garden, though.
It's a beer garden, yes. I fully agree with you. It's a beer garden, but it's not a brew house.
Oh, you wanted a debate. There you go.
Well,
you said debate.
Does Hofbräu brew at every location around the country?
You said a brew house.
I meant a beer house.
Yeah. Okay, that works. I agree with you, but that's not what I
thought. German's not that good.
I guess we had our... German and American English confused.
There you go. Well,
I mostly speak Spanish.
You were speaking in Canadian again.
Yeah,
well,
words.
Them all up.
Words actually. Words actually just confused. Yeah. Cowboy. Just words.
I'm confused by words by now. You know, because we've been drinking this beautiful, beautiful four-finger rye whiskey from 1205.
It's delicious, isn't it?
It's good stuff.
Yeah.
You know, I apologize. I'm looking right at Cowboy right now.
Yeah.
There's no sense to apologize to him.
We get that a lot.
I see four of him right now. I think that's why they call it four-finger.
Cover one eye, you'll only see two.
I don't even know which way's up. So, but we were just talking about... our preference, because right about now, can we talk about this?
Sure.
Please do.
Halloween 2018.
Yes.
versus 1978, which one? Where are we at with this, folks?
We were talking
Jamie
about this
Lee
off
Curtis
the,
is like
the new Halloween. Okay,
yeah,
right.
Dude,
wait, didn't they just
yeah,
didn't
bro.
They? It's the another new Halloween. They didn't they? They did H2O, and it was like okay, yeah. whatever. And then,
but zombies don't count. Rob Zombie, they don't.
Isn't
count.
He really a zombie? Isn't,
no.
isn't
we can't
you know,
we
zombie?
Can't count that because they suck. Oh, so okay. Rob so, Zombie's done one good movie, Devil Rejects. Everything else has been
pretty
shit.
Pretty much, yeah.
So
House of Thousand Corpses was no. god awful.
It was. It was.
Thank
yes.
God. I,
yes.
I'm glad everybody agrees.
Yes.
But I did like the remakes, the Halloween remakes.
Really?
Yeah, I did.
I never got into the Halloween movies. It just wasn't my thing.
I mean, anything with Busta Rhymes in it, you go ahead and throw that in the trash.
Well, yeah.
I'm glad everybody gets the reference. If you didn't get the reference, I was going to be like, well, crickets.
We can put, don't worry, we can put that sound effect in.
The reference. But anything. Anyway, I really did like his remakes.
All I right. just, I swear to God, sometimes a genre has one defining movie, and it is Halloween 1978.
Yes.
Michael Myers.
Absolutely.
Jamie Lee
agree.
Curtis.
Absolutely.
That scene, I'm just going to say, that scene where Michael Myers... She thought she killed him, and he does that sit up.
Yes, yes.
In the background,
and that the most freaky thing.
In the unfocused yeah. background, is the scariest fucking thing I've ever witnessed.
But
in my
but
life.
And they try.
I just got chills.
But they try to redo that in almost every horror movie now. Is
yeah,
the,
yeah
is,
of course.
He's dead. No, he's not dead. I mean that is a something they do in every freaking movie now.
No, you can't recreate that. You can't. Right. It wasn't and you know what?
Yeah.
It wasn't in HD, was it? It was in low D or whatever the fuck that was. You know?
But what they did do very well in that movie was the element of surprise. So where you thought something was going to happen. Didn't actually happen, but then when you didn't expect it is when it actually happened. So
well, that's one of the starts of those archetypal patterns, though.
But
it's the archetype of a horror movie.
But Halloween
they started it.
Like, did Bach compose that or something? Because it feels like that has been,
had to have been
since
yeah.
like forever. That song is so classic. I'm a musician by training too. By
really?
The way. Oh yeah, yeah. Tuba.
How
you're
the
welcome.
Hell did we not? Tuba. Okay, now we get it.
No, I'm just saying, but I know.
Cowboy
I know
plays it. The butt trumpet.
Yeah.
But I will say that's song, that little riff.
Yeah.
It's not even a song, it's just like a riff.
Yeah. If you hear that, you.
Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun, dun, your mind takes
dude,
you to dark places.
Like everyone gets chills when they
oh,
hear that.
I do just so.
Even if you've never heard the.
Yeah.
The
I DJed
I
for
think there's been
12 years, and I had to play that song on Halloween night. I just played that riff for like 2 minutes, you know, of that song, you know, that just for. At a dance club, I'm DJing in nightclubs.
Every
clubs.
Other song,
yeah.
You got you like, to think that and Jaws, those riffs, everybody knows, and it means something when you hear it. It brings you to a place, no matter where what context it's in. If
was
you hear the Jaws or the Halloween,
yeah, you're right.
Halloween's
yeah.
a doo-doo. What's the? There's another. What's the other? Is that
Friday?
Friday 13th.
Yeah.
That's the other
Hot
one.
Hot Pockets.
Yeah.
It's not as good as your bi-menin.
Hot
hey.
Pocket.
It's not as good as your bi-menin, but it's still good.
By the way, get your fresh Hot Pockets at Pearl Street. Oh, wait, calzones, I mean, whatever, you know.
So what was your guys' first your first horror movie experience?
Nightmare on Elm
you remember
Street.
You as a kid?
Nightmare on Elm Street.
Nightmare on Elm Street.
Mine
really?
Was Nightmare on Elm Street.
That scared you, too. I mean,
that scared the shit out of me, because there was a house not too far down from ours. That was the Nightmare on, I mean, I swear to it was on Arlington, and I lived on Arlington and Washington.
Right?
But yeah, it was Nightmare on Arlington Street. There was one like, there was a house like 15 houses down from where I lived,
yeah,
and it was on my paper route.
No, right across the street from
the CVS.
We
thought it was the murder house. That was not the one I'm talking about.
Oh,
but,
really?
Yeah, no,
which
I,
one?
I don't remember that one. No, this was
it was,
it was down from the Village
Pantry.
Well, about.
The CVS,
yeah. There was a Village Pantry on the corner of Arlington and Washington, and about 15 houses towards... was it Slippery Noodle was down that way or something? There was one of there was a bar my uncle used to play in down the way. Can't remember if it's north, south, east, or west because I'm horrible at that. But that's creeped the shit out of me because I saw that and I know it's not a Halloween movie, but it was Nightmare on Elm Street and Alien.
Alien, yeah.
I know it wasn't a Halloween, but that those were the first two.
Everybody
like, scary,
knows that aliens aren't real.
Scary movie shit that I. Those were the first two and. I was 6 or 7 when I was allowed to watch those. I'm sorry, not allowed to watch those, but when I actually got to see them. Yeah. Those were mine. Freddy Krueger was my nightmare. You know, my first horror. I didn't get into the Halloween and the Friday the 13th stuff as much as I did that one. What was yours, Summer?
I have to say the first one was Poltergeist.
Oh my god. Oh,
I didn't even think about it. You're right.
Poltergeist, yeah.
That
tree.
Yeah. It was a Halloween movie. I didn't think tree. About it. The tree and the clown. Tree and that clown.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was some
Not
then,
to mention, if you're anything into TV, yeah, fuck you.
Or the dude, well, it was really creepy. The dude, when he's like in the mirror and he starts scratching his face and just starts taking all his skin off.
Yep.
You're just like, yeah.
Poltergeist, solid choice.
Solid choice. I like it. Dave?
I was the first one my brother and I snuck out and watched. But my parents was Dawn of the Dead.
Oh yeah.
That scene where they were they like trapped themselves in the house and all the zombies were coming at them.
Yeah.
And I was like, I don't know, 8.
Yeah. And you're just and all of a sudden you any knock on the door.
We
just,
were,
yeah.
Well, and we were getting babysat. We were at a
your babysitter was horrible.
Well, and they no, we,
I disagree. I disagree.
My parent no, they were awesome. We're like, no, our parents said this is cool to watch.
Oh, okay.
We were convincing, but we were staying at their farm. They lived on a farm in the middle of fucking nowhere. So, yeah. I mean,
it worked out. Yeah. Oh yeah.
It added to that scare factor.
Oh, hell yeah! And then Children of the Corn came out recently.
Holy shit! That was a good one.
It really was. I mean, that when Children it first came out when you were a kid, because like I said. Movies have changed so much now, but back then when Children of Corn came out, it was freaky, man.
Yeah.
It was. Malachi.
Are you kidding me? Yeah.
Man,
Malachi was that dude. That little
Come
dude
on,
was
man.
Weird. Yeah. They found the perfect guy to play that.
Yeah.
The perfect actor.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Wasn't the same guy? No, he didn't play Damien. No, that was a different one. Damien was a good one, too. Damien back
movie.
In the day.
Ooh, yeah.
Or no, Damien 2. I didn't
Damien.
See Damien originally.
Yeah.
I saw Damien
yeah.
2.
The Electric
When he was
Boogaloo.
In, like, the... Yeah.
I think
yeah,
to
with,
me,
I'm glad you had a couple drinks too.
Yeah. Damien 2, Electric Boogaloo. Beautiful. I like it. That one where he was in the like military, you know, academy or one. Yeah.
Yep.
That was Police Academy. It was Damien 2, Electric Boogaloo, Police Academy, Miami. What?
That one scared the hell out of me.
Yeah, oh yeah. The Rusty Bucket.
Horrible production.
I still say one of my favorite horror movies is When a Stranger Calls, the original.
What the hell is that?
Have you not seen When a Stranger Calls?
You mean Scream? Wait, no.
No, pre-Scream.
I'm in your house.
Yeah, I mean, that's where Scream came from.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't know
right,
that one,
yeah,
know that one at all.
Yeah.
Really?
Who was in that?
Check the Children.
Oh, my God. Dude,
who was in that?
It's one of...
Is it black and white?
It's nobody cast, but it is a fantastic movie, and, I mean, it really gets you thinking. Right.
Yeah. No, I don't. I'll have to look that one up. No,
well,
I
and I wonder, though, there's different people. There's people that get scared by, like, gore. There's people that get scared by the surprise, like,
Yeah.
And then there's the people that get scared
thriller
by... Yeah, the weird, vibe. Like, fantasy ghost. Yeah. Dude, I love talking about this kind of stuff. So I want to talk about... I don't want to hijack this conversation.
No,
I want to talk about the last Blair Witch that where
the first.
Listen. Yeah. No, because there's something about like if you get like messed up in the head, and that's what that last one was all about. I don't know if you guys all said it, but or have seen it, but that like people were like the witch, and I'm using air quotes here. It was a total mind fuck.
Yeah, I played baseball at this baseball diamonds. And next door was this house in the fucking woods. So outside of the baseball diamonds was nothing but woods for like 3.5 miles. But there was a house in the back of the woods. So everybody got freaked out as a child because they thought a witch lived in that house. So Blair Witch resonated with me. I absolutely agree with what you're saying right now.
I guess I watched another one, which was like a Swedish version of the Blair Witch.
Yeah, yeah.
I forget what the name of it was, but it was along the same lines where it was psychological. It was almost like psychedelic, I guess, if you will say, you know, because they didn't
know. Ron Jeremy was in it.
They didn't know.
caught him off guard. Sorry.
Not everybody has had the same life experience as me.
No,
so.
But
no, I'm sorry. I was just getting
Blair Witch. Is that's a freaky situation? Yeah.
What's freakier than losing your mind? Is I guess my point is like that's the scariest thing that can happen to you. Is
oh, yeah.
If you don't know which way is
that's
real. Or
those are
not
the ones
real.
that always
that's
freak
what
me
scares
out.
Me
is,
the
is
most.
Not the gore and stuff. They're not scary.
Yeah.
You know, it's mostly usually they're funny because they're so gory, and it's just more hilarity than anything else. But it's the ones that can actually happen. Like you were mentioning, I mean, Halloween and the stuff that just messes with your head that you could be at home and this shit could happen. And
this is a possibility.
Yeah.
Yeah. I had a problem with it, Summer. I don't know what's your Blair Witch. Do you like Blair Witch at all? I don't like the found footage. I'm air quoting too on the radio.
Well, it was so bad.
I don't like the found footage movies. I don't like it. Any of those. That's why I didn't like Blair Witch at all.
The acting was so ridiculous, and it was just awful.
I mean, their
awful
marketing
movie.
Was great because people thought it was real at first. You know, people were like, oh, they actually found this shit. And again, I'm like,
well, you idiots.
Okay.
Do you guys watch American Horror Story?
I do not.
I've not watched
I
this
did.
Season.
Really?
Yeah, I've not started
season was
it.
Once Lady Gaga got on there,
I feel like, you're,
I feel
like
there,
you're the person that would have with
I've
me.
I've watched several of the seasons, and I think it was the...
Last season, where it was the presidential?
Yeah, I only watched
Why is everybody air-quoting on the radio now?
Yeah, it's like...
Because I knew she would get what I'm talking about, yeah. Except for the last season, I watched the first three episodes, and I was like, all right, seriously, are you kidding me? This is just a presidential debate type thing? I'm like, all right, throw this in the trash, and I didn't finish watching it. But... I understand where people are, like, horrified by this because there are people thriving on this and throwing their horror situations into regular situations nowadays.
Yeah, I couldn't watch it when Lady Gaga came out.
Really? You didn't like that season?
I don't like
Lady
Gaga.
No, her without makeup is fucking hot.
Oh, no, scary. No, what are you talking about? She used to be a man.
I don't... Okay, if that's what you think a man looks like, I understand why you've been single for the past 8 years.
She has an Adam's apple. Shut up. She has an Adam's apple, and you know it.
Have you seen anything recent? Because I'm still looking for that shit that scared the hell out of me as a kid, because there were times when I didn't want to go upstairs at night because I was scared shitless after watching Halloween.
Okay.
But I like that high that I got off it, but I haven't found that anymore.
I don't think so, because... Really?
But I don't know if it'd be considered a Halloween movie. It's not a Halloween movie, but it's scary. To be honest, a quiet
it's an Easter movie,
a Quiet Place.
I've heard that's good.
Yeah, yeah.
There's literally not a lot of dialogue, it's quite frightening if you're watching it alone at the house, and you know if
oh wait a minute
if you've got a good insulated house and there's not a lot of sounds coming from anywhere, it's rather spooky and it worked well for me. I knew the premise that was coming up anyways, right. But because I've watched far too many movies over my years, and so I know what's actually going to happen. But you really thought it would? I thought it was going to be boring as shit because nobody's talking. Everybody's sign language and stuff for a while, or everything's really hushed down. You know, and I thought it was just going to be boring stuff, and not necessarily
Sixth
a Halloween
Sense.
Movie. But that one got me just because my misconception of what it would be.
I agree. There was one scary thing I watched there the other week. I turned it to Fox News.
There you go. Oh, I knew that was coming.
I haven't done that in years. I'm not ready for that. So yeah.
I'd still like to sleep at night. I don't want to know.
Yeah. MSNBC, way better.
Has there been any good Halloween movies lately? I mean, really?
No.
Didn't Saw try to reinvent itself to something else? Jigsaw.
No, like that wasn't a reinvent.
Did anybody watch that?
But all that stuff was just gore and it's
I can't
not
watch
scary.
Saw.
It's just... I don't.
If you take it for what
think,
it is,
I think
be
the
scared.
Magic of scariness is sometimes is it's that campfire, sit around and
clear out.
Like we don't want special effects or anything. Like that's why we talk about the old school movies.
Campy,
you know, right?
Yeah.
You know? I want stuff that's in the head that you like. You know, it could happen and it makes you think.
Well, I
don't want to be scared.
That's
the again.
Scariest thing is this could literally fucking happen.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
I think as you get older, though, you lose. It's as we've all we're all in our late, you know, we're older now, and so it's hard to get that.
We're not scared. We want something to fucking
kill us.
Right,
but there's nothing to it. Yes,
just kill me.
I'm scared of keeping working.
Right.
I think the main
not being able to retire.
You're married again.
Jesus.
And on that note, we need to take a break.
All right, so let's take a break. We'll come right back, and we're going to go a little more on the Halloween stuff.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cheers.
This is Dan Gore from Redemption Ale Works, and thank you for listening to the Blind Pig Confessions.
And we're drinking Four Finger Whiskey, and right. No one else can notice right now.
I like that he's now on our level.
He is. He's at our level.
Hey.
So we were talking.
He
we
listens
talking
so
our,
well.
We were talking our Halloween movies and things. Did we get around to everybody with our Halloween? Summer, did you? Yeah, yours was Poltergeist.
Poltergeist.
Brendan, did you name
Sound
one?
Of Music by my.
I tell you what, with the Flying Nun, scary as shit.
No, Halloween was the thing that scared the shit out of me as a kid, and I was too young. I had to sneak in to watch it because I was, you know, underage, and you know, brothers were watching it. It scared the shit out of me, and I'm always looking now, still looking for that high of just being scared. I love that feeling because it was an awesome feeling. Even though I was scared shitless, I didn't want to go upstairs.
But I think we lived in
an old brick house, you know, this huge old brick house. I had to go upstairs. After that, I was scared shitless to go to bed at night by myself because of that fucking movie.
All right. So that explains your relationship with your brother.
And every girlfriend, yeah. So I'm still looking, but I'm still looking for that high, you know what I mean?
But you love going downstairs.
Oh, I do love going
downstairs all day long.
it's funny you bring up your family in this because... My family won. Halloween took me to see Child's Play.
Really?
Yeah.
The original one was good.
Oh, come on.
The original one was good.
No, time out. I'm way younger than you, so go fuck off.
He is. He's still on.
But no, I wanted to talk about that because it is different because the game changed when you were born.
When Child's Play, were you born back
93 or something?
86.
Youngins.
But it was completely different. There's already the change of they had special effects and coming into play.
But at the time, I didn't have anything compared to. But at Christmas time, they bought me a My Buddy doll.
Oh,
so
no
I open it and think, fuck you, and throw it. So they took me to, in which they
my
had to,
buddy.
I had to leave halfway through my the buddy. Movie. Because I was scared shitless because I was a kid. Anyway, yes, I was. I was 2 to your 22. And so when Christmas came along and they bought me a My Buddy doll, they thought, hilarious.
Best parents ever then right now. I'm liking that. Yeah.
So I was in sixth grade. I had a birthday party. And my brother thought it would be hilarious to tell my mom that the only thing I wanted was parachute pants. And... I opened up this package.
So scary. So scary.
I opened up the package of parachute pants, and I was so fucking pissed. I started crying at my birthday party because I was so mad. I'm like, you son of a bitch. My brother said it was hilarious, you know? Because they told my mom, that's the only thing he wants is parachute pants. They don't even remember it because it didn't mean anything to them. That was huge to me.
Brendan 2, Electric Boogaloo. We get back to the Electric Boogaloo again.
Talking about Christmas, there's a newer movie out a couple years back called... I talked about this. Crepitus. Hey, I'll tell you what, Bill Moseley. Me and my daughter, Lindsay, went to L.A. and went to see the screening of Crepitus. It was pretty cool to see Bill Moseley meet these guys.
Yeah.
Of course, our buddies Haynes and, for fuck's sake,
I don't know.
Eddie.
Haynes and Eddie.
Eddie Mobley?
Haynes and Eddie and his wife, Sarah, wrote Crepitus and kick ass. But Bill Moseley's kind of like, the god of horror movies.
Bill,
I mean, he really is. Everybody knows Bill Moseley.
Well, I mean, it was originally known as more like the B-movie thing. But even Bill, like, getting on to Devil's Rejects and all that.
Right.
Bill Moseley is
he's like,
just,
you know,
he's a staple of horror kind of, you know, stuff.
Yeah, you know the guys from horror. Bill Moseley's kind of the guy from horror now. But there's a movie called, it's a Finnish movie, Rare Exports, and I keep telling people to watch this movie because it incorporates Christmas and Halloween.
Is that the one that's kind of illegal in a couple countries?
No. Rare Exports is a must-see.
Okay.
It's an incredible movie, and it's a Halloween movie, but it's about Christmas and Santa Claus, the real Santa Claus before the Krampus shit came out.
Okay.
But it's
I was
going to
say, don't say Krampus.
Don't say Krampus.
But it's done very well, okay. And it's creepy, and it's a great movie. You have to see Rare Exports if you love Halloween and love Christmas and
it's
love.
Not Wetlands. Love, is
oh, no.
No, we're not going
Wetlands
there.
Is a horror on a whole new level. And yeah, that's a must see. It's a good, yeah.
So we are.
You talk about that a lot. You like Wetlands, didn't you?
I do. I do love Wetlands.
Yeah, that first 10 minutes is definitely a horror movie all itself.
If you can make it through the first 5 minutes, you can make it through the whole movie.
Yeah.
But we're in Pearl Street, and I keep getting this waft of garlic.
Are you a vampire?
No, but I love it. It's fantastic.
What's your favorite horror movie?
Favorite, not just one you're introduced to.
Do you even have a recent one now that
what
kinda
scared?
No,
hey,
recent Halloween movies, they're not good.
No. I just want to say, by the way, I'm going to hijack this for a moment.
Shocking.
We are going to, it's not if.
Fired.
No, it's not if, it's when.
Bye.
Oh, he did it on air, that's awful.
Shed it.
She didn't mean that. I'm going to scare literally the shit out of Summer Harper.
I hope you do.
And it's going to be caught on video.
Yeah.
I'm liking that.
She doesn't believe it.
She's going to
shit.
No,
I believe it.
Oh, you do believe it?
Yeah.
You think it's going to happen?
She's going to shit herself.
I was told that as soon as the cameras went up that I was going to be scared.
It's a precursor.
So every time I turn
so it's
a corner
no,
now,
it's no
I'm
surprise
like,
that the when she sees a camera, she knows. It's like, da-da.
I told him that's fine.
You know what the beauty?
Like Jaws, yeah.
That's kind of the beauty about like some of the technology you got nowadays. You can sit like a little Bluetooth speaker somewhere and just start fucking with someone who's closing late at night or, you know. Oh.
Don't give any of my secrets away.
Yeah.
Summer. The funny thing is Summer is a huge, huge.
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 My penis is huge.
That was funny. We need to
speaking of scary stuff.
That was hilarious.
Thanks, she's Cowboy. A huge horror Halloween person. But she's
I'm
such
glad you preference that.
I know. Me too. I'm like, damn it, Dave, seriously.
At least he finished the word.
He's
horror.
Only known me for 8 months. How does he know?
It's all over. It's all over.
I don't know.
We've heard from so many people.
The internet.
You have a skeleton friend, okay? Come on.
We talked to the whole state of Kentucky.
Loose lips sink ships.
So I know we've talked about movies.
Loose lips?
We talked about movies, okay? I wanted to switch it up, a little Halloween other thing. Do any of you still go to, or I know I have in the past, but it's been a long time. And I'll have a story on that. Yeah.
Skyline
haunted
movie
houses.
Theater.
Do any of you still, as an adult, do you go to haunted houses at all?
So I went last year.
To
and
what?
I made,
you made what?
Well, no.
She made 50
I made
bucks.
Friends go with.
Giving blowjobs.
Wow. 50? How much?
Damn.
I don't know.
That was a good corn maze. Very good corn maze.
So anyways, the one that has the four different houses.
Necropolis?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that one's been around for
ages.
20 years now. Yeah.
But
I think
I
went to that in high school.
Yeah, and one of my friends hates being scared, so I made her get drunk first.
Oh, that's going to work out well.
So, literally in the first haunted house, we're walking, and some guy runs up and scares her. And she's like, Summer, I peed my pants.
Oh, no shit.
People in front of us are laughing.
Oh, no shit.
My other friend just keeps farting. And she goes, I'm sorry, guys. I just fart when I get nervous. I'm like, I can't go to a haunted house with you people ever again. Like, what is happening right now?
Why did I choose you?
Yeah. I'm like, times.
Oh, that's horrible. Do any of you guys have you gone?
I disagree. That is
years?
Not horrible.
No,
that's
that
funny.
Was great.
Yeah.
That was great.
Dave, have you
I
been to a
still
haunted
send
house?
A text out
have you been to a haunted house in years?
I like the old school like hay bale mazes. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I like those.
Oh, yeah.
So Brendan, you've been to a haunted house in forever?
It's been a while. I used to go to the one in Mackinac, and that one scared the shit out of me when I was a kid. But now they just. I went to the one in Noblesville, and that's been a few years back, but it didn't scare me. It was more fun. But it was fun.
Yeah.
It was very fun. I thought it was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
But it didn't scare me.
course.
So, again,
but I'm looking
for that.
I think
the scary,
a movie. I don't think you can get the scary part as
I
you
disagree.
Get older.
There was
no,
a movie, House of Hoverville. Did anybody see that? Mm. It was somebody on an adventure to actually go to a haunted house that actually would scare them, and then they went somewhere where there was more going on than just scaring. So, but it was actually kind of creepy. It was actually kind of a recent, cool horror movie that was different and based around the things that you're looking for as from childhood as being scared. So it was kind of a cool movie. But I don't know. The horror
it's
house
so
is...
It's so harder to get scared as you get older, though.
You do because you're not innocent anymore.
You're just you're
desensitized. I think that has a lot to do with it. Is a kid seeing stuff like Halloween as a kid, especially in the 70s.
Adult life is way scarier.
Adult
life
is
scarier.
Holy crap, I can't pay my rent. What?
That's exactly
We've
right.
all had girlfriends and boyfriends.
Declared
so
bankruptcy
else
three
right.
times.
Opening the bank accounts
Exactly. Yeah.
Well, when your girlfriend comes at you with a knife, I mean, that's just...
Right.
So that's like every other week for you, right?
Well,
Cowboy, have you been to a haunted house in a while? Do you take the girls? Are they old enough to go to a haunted house, or do you bother?
No. The scariest thing I treat them to is you.
Oh, well. Uncle Patrick. Here comes Uncle Patrick.
Does anybody have any, reoccurring dreams that scare the shit out of them?
I do, actually, yeah.
Do you really?
So,
this going to be what ping again?
Show?
Or?
Every time
no,
we gotta
no,
do a show?
No, this is really weird, but I still have it maybe once a year. When I was a kid, I used to have this reoccurring dream where it was about once a year, I would plug a Super Nintendo controller into my leg, and I would play Mortal Kombat against live-action Mortal Kombat in my dreams. And still, once a year, I relive this dream.
Weird. I do have one.
I think we need to go back to this because for one, I thought you were going to plug it into somewhere else. I'm glad it was your leg. But why was this scary?
No, I mean you would play Liu Kang or whatever once a year. I mean, legitimately, it was scary as fuck to me as a kid.
Who were you? Just you?
Just me. So I didn't have any superpowers.
Like,
so I wouldn't have like bestiality or friendship.
So you're just like in a ball as this guy beat the shit out of you.
Yeah,
pretty much.
Yeah.
Did you say bestiality.
Yeah.
I mean, did he like freeze you or fire you first, and then
it depends on who I was fighting. Yeah.
Get over here.
Yeah, I mean, there was a scorpion.
Get over here,
or Sub Zero would freeze.
Well,
the
I would really like to talk
like
to
six
more
arms
80s
four
babies
arms.
To see if that's a thing because that's
it is
weird.
Not.
I mean, legitimately, I mean, I would, and it's funny, it always started out, I would leave my grandma's house, I was heading to the car or whatever, and as soon as I got out of the car, Liu Kang or Sub-Zero or somebody showed up, and I would have to battle him.
Yeah.
Wow, you have problems.
I don't know.
Wow, yeah. I don't think we can fix this in the time we have left in the show.
No.
We're not going to be able to unpack that at all.
I never wanted you to... Like, fix this.
I'm just telling you what happened
in my childhood. Yes. Go fuck yourself.
I think this is a perfect place to talk about this is Halloween.
Yeah. All right.
It's pretty fucking
scary.
It's okay.
We're gonna put a pin in that one. Not just a Canadian issue.
That is a whole nother show.
Now
right
we
there.
Have this Sub-Zero shit. Yeah.
Wait, are you Canadian?
No.
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 I think he is. He just
he had
I think
a bad
that's
experience
the problem.
In Canada.
No, I don't like Canada.
I don't think he ever went
he
to Canada.
Like, you don't like Canada.
He was in. He never went to Canada.
That's a disgusting.
He
place.
Was in Kansas. He's never been to Canada.
Kansas.
His parents told him he was in Canada. He was just in a.
He
some,
didn't know.
In, yeah,
he was in Lebanon.
Yeah, he was.
Like Palestine.
He was.
Yeah,
he was.
No,
in
he's
some
in
weird
New Pal right now.
He was in some
Lebanon.
Weird Amish community where they're.
I live
him.
In New Pal.
Well, no, we
Palestine.
Were actually, no. To surprise you, may not know this. Like, so about a third of our downloads every week from our listeners are literally from Lebanon, not Lebanon,
right,
Indiana.
Yeah.
No, the University of Lebanon. I shit you not.
I
you're
believe you.
It
I
is
believe
the weirdest
you.
Thing.
But, I believe you. You guys are weird enough. I believe you.
Makes perfect sense.
So I'm going back to just a little bit because I'm not. So I don't go to haunted houses anymore, mainly because I might not be allowed.
That's
well, yeah. The ordinance.
Last haunted house I went to might have been Necropolis. No, it was something. But I did get kicked out. I got kicked out of a haunted house
because he touched little girls.
Because they touched me. No, yeah. So when wow. I was like, when I was like, eight, when I was 18
that,
years old,
that did not make that any better.
No, it didn't. No. When I was 18 years old, I was very jumpy and angry. I was very kind of jumpy and angry, and they're not supposed to like physically touch you at any point in a haunted house. And they touched me, and I turned around and I punched a guy in the stomach because he actually touched me on the shoulders. And then they kicked me out, but he touched me. Yeah. It's his fault. You know what are you gonna say? But yeah, I don't. So I don't go to haunted houses anymore. Just cause.
Or strip joints.
Well,
she got naked right in front of me.
she rubbed her cooch right on my face.
Bitch touched me. I fucking tall up and punched her. You're not supposed to touch me.
I don't deal with that.
I can't touch you. You can't touch me.
I did hear there was like a new haunted house where they really like put a bag over your head and then end up putting you in a room and they take the bag off. But all the people have night vision.
We gotta give
goggles.
Dave a moment.
Dave,
you made him cry.
Moment.
This makes me happy beyond control.
He's wiping away tears.
I still have.
He's like, I think he's had that problem in the strip joint. I think that's why it's so funny. It's funny because it's true.
I have
visions of me doing what?
Not like obviously not true.
No, he's gonna have nightmares for Halloween.
We all are now. Yeah. Oh, for fuck's sake!
That stripper touched me. Damn it, no.
No means no. All right, so we fucked this show all up.
No, we didn't. We had a great show.
No, we
didn't. The show's been really good, man. We've talked about, you know, our movies and punching people who touch you.
Yeah.
Punching pie.
Cowboys problems with Nintendo or Mortal Kombat or
that
whatever.
Was super
that
Nintendo.
Thank you. What we need to do is next Halloween, we actually talk about, we have some movies that we throw out together.
Yeah,
as a team, Dave, Summer, we can actually watch them stuff that scared you as a kid, and maybe new movies that we can actually talk about next Halloween.
That'd be
good. Mortal Kombat.
Yeah,
Mortal Kombat was a horrible
video
Halloween
games,
movie.
Whatever. I mean, yeah. So that'd be kind of fun next year to actually have a Pearl Street. And Vinny's gonna, you know, he's gonna talk next
Vinny
year maybe.
Well, we'll get it this year. We got Bluetooth technology. We can make that boy talk.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's gonna be awesome.
Well, but it's a year from now. It'd be animated by next year.
He might actually be able to bring it back to life.
Yeah. He'll probably run our show by then.
He just didn't drink enough this year.
Yeah.
Vinny needs to drink more. He looks dead tired. You know.
Put him on.
Made her laugh. Don't care about you fuckers.
All right, Pearl Street. Dave, Summer,
Dave,
love
Summer,
you guys.
Thank
this
you
is
guys.
Awesome.
I'm having a good time.
Yeah, we talked Halloween out. This week, but of course, you come here for the pizza and the great food and the great beer. You got sports all over the. It really is a good
place
for weekends to come and watch football.
Oh yeah,
any sport.
We've only
gotten
a few awkward stares from the people at the bar.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I do that every day. So
yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm used to that. So
they'll get used to it.
Go. Cowboy made a friend in the bathroom.
I did, as always.
As always.
I don't know why you're laughing.
It's a signature thing. I shit you not. It's a signature thing. He will find a friend in the bathroom.
Oh, yeah. You missed that conversation.
Yeah, I mean, I am like.
He likes to talk to people in the bathroom.
Yeah, it's not that I like to. It's just what's happened.
Yeah, you did.
What happened? What happened in the bathroom?
I go put my wing in my hand and I pee and I make friends.
Somebody starts talking to him. It's what happens.
It's just that simple.
It is. It literally is that simple. It's just cowboy. It's that simple. That's how it goes.
Puts his wiener in his hand, and some guy goes, "Hey, how you doing?"
I feel like there's more there.
there is.
I feel like we should Dateline investigate this.
Yeah. Then he starts playing Mortal Kombat.
Mortal Kombat!
Get over here!
All right, cheers, guys. Love you.
Cheers.
Cheers.